In 1989, I was a student here. I came for a 1 month course on basic telecommunication science. After I worked on the wavelet, I wrote a formula. They told me it was important for image processing, and then I requested my advisor to send me here. I spent a month here, and it was very important. Later on, I didn't know that I was going to become a minister in charge of IT, and I think the course I had here in telecommunication science was very, very helpful. So the contributor to the session on Africa, Morocco, Senegal, Cameroon, Nigeria, Egypt, Senegal, South Africa, Tunisia, Uganda, Zambia, Zimbabwe. And also we have also the interaction from the audience. In particular, we have the World Bank, and also we have also the director of ICTP asked two questions. What can ICTP do for you? What can you do for ICTP? And also he asked the question on GDP. So those who intervened spoke about several issues and some challenges. Science is global and need to grow both in the South and the North. The importance of science societies such as the African Physical Society, also local academies are very important in promoting science capacity and building a networking. Inadequate human resources in S&T throughout the education system. Zimbabwe science and needs action both from top down to bottom up. The importance of communication from scientists to scientists and scientists to society. The inequity, gender inequity in science and technology. And also the issue of HIV is very important. Across the board in Africa, scientists and human capital is being depleted due to, unfortunately, HIV. And also need to increase human capital mobility that was also mentioned, south to south, very, very limited. You have more south to north, people going to study, but also brain drain, but also very limited north to south, but more than south to south. Efficient use of diaspora, not only to have permanent physical presence. People will say, oh, why don't you come? But you realize, actually, sometimes the government of the countries where these people are from are not even don't want these people to come back. So sometimes it's not even easy for a scientist to return back. But you can put visiting scientist program, visiting professorship, co-supervising of thesis, also engage in collaborative work. This can be very important. The African continent is bound with contradictory. Some universities are very, very well equipped. For example, South Africa has very, very good universities, but there are some universities really where they are completely destitute. Also, African Union has committed 1% of GDP, although that has not been attained, but most countries are trying. For example, I know Rwanda has already reached, at least by 2008, 1.6% of GDP for science and technology. How can ICTP help? There is a range of issues there. Due to the need for good justification for financial support to S&T R&D, ICTP can be used as a financial channel able to supervise and monitor the result of such financial support. ICTP can play the role of channeling and harmonizing donor intervention on the continent. There are several initiatives, one in science and technology, in particular in physical sciences. So one can go down on the list, localize many of its schools in Africa. ICT can partner with African institutions in postgraduate education and physics supervision. ICT can help Africa in drawing the map for specific S&T needs, sensitize the World Bank and other funding agencies to allocate more resources in S&T R&D, emphasize regional collaboration, focusing on specific area in a given region. For example, biotechnology was mentioned. How can we help ICTP? Partner with ICTP in mobilizing resources for activities in Africa. Help ICTP presence visible in Africa. The African Union can help in achieving these two initiatives. Some continental initiatives. The African Minister Conference of Science and Technology started in 2003 in Johannesburg, South Africa. It convenes every 2 years, in Senegal 2005, Kenya 2007, and Egypt 2009. I was in the 2003 meeting, and then I was in the 2007 meeting. Head of State African Union Summit in January 2007, the conference, actually the head of state, the head of state, the theme, major theme was information communication technology in Africa, challenges and prospect for development. In particular, when Professor Azin came with the head of ITU to request the president of Rwanda to be the main speaker at the conference, I am the one who took them to the president to see him. That was just before I left cabinet in July 2009. They came in June 2007. And then you have several other initiatives that you can see there. There are very positive initiatives. For example, the African Institute of Mathematical Sciences. When I was still Minister of Education, I went to teach there. I visited there. They do a lot of good stuff. They've trained more than 200 mathematicians. If these mathematicians, some of them have gone to do PhD, some of them are working in areas such as financial mathematics, they're working in epidemiology, and so forth. So this is very important. Some other initiatives. But the summit of January 2010 was very, very important. You see there, these three, you see four people there. You have the president of the World Bank, the president of Rwanda. Behind you, you have the secretary general of ITU, International Telecommunication Union. Behind you have the president of the African Development Bank. And then you have one of the persons in the African Union Commission. And they all spoke about the importance of information communication technology, in particular broadband, in particular the undersea cable around Africa. President Zuma not only spoke about that, but also he mentioned the square kilometer array. This is at the heart of we are physicists here, so this is very, very important. If the South Africa wins the bid, it will be very important for all of us in terms of building capacity, also using networking in information communication technologies. Donat Kaberuka, the president of the African Development Bank, actually spoke also about science and technology, but in particular, the issue of infrastructure. And that he talked about that. The missing link is the black line. And the World Bank, if you read the statement from the president of the World Bank, the last paragraph, he speaks about investing in the submarine cable. Conclusion. My colleague today from the Minister of Zimbabwe, who's here, I hope I'm quoting him right. So African Union has committed 1% GDP to S&T R&D, although this has not been attained by most of the countries, at least it is a commitment we can work on. I thank you.